According to MP Joel Leku, cases of parents abandoning children have increased across the country due to the resurgence of household poverty, thus calling on poor men to forget about sex instead of filling the country with children they cannot look after.
Ugandans think they marry and produce children for the government, not knowing that this is your own blood and you should take care of the person and see him grow, nurture him as a good citizen of this country. But the men go and they abandon children. And these are mostly lazy men, poor and lazy men. These ones will have to leave our daughters alone.
He made the remarks during a press conference at Parliament with members of Uganda Parliamentary Forum for Children, together with Child's Foundation, that is leading calls on child care reforms by decampaigning orphanage centers for family-based care. Margaret Makoka, the chairperson of Uganda Parliamentary Forum for Children, also spurred at fellow MPs who impregnate girlfriends and abandon their offspring. She warned that the forum will not hesitate to make public the names of the perpetrators if they don't abandon the practice of abandoning their children.
Why should you be a member of parliament who gets some good money and you cannot take care of your lover? To the extent that these children can be abandoned, neglected, and at worst taken to even institutions to be raised. So if we don't stop it, fellow members, we are going to name and shame you and put you to the public.
Last year, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, threatened to name and shame male MPs who abandoned their lovers with offsprings, a vice that has seen women flock to Parliament pleading for her intervention. However, Bukoli North MP Stefan Baka said MPs shouldn't be the only group pointed out because the vice of abandoning children is global and shouldn't be treated as a reserve for lawmakers in Uganda.
We are addressing this matter wholesomely. Whether MPs have been found to be falling short of the standards of taking care of their children, it's a global problem. It's not about Uganda, it's not about Parliament, it's not about it. It's a global problem.
It's a social problem.
It's a big problem. So we are talking about it wholesomely. That instead of pointing an idea or the other, let us holistically approach the situation in terms of looking at the family as the best unit.
I doubt whether there is a woman who can neglect the child and say, let me take you to an orphanage, I will not take care of you. But it is common with the men. And like you've said, even members of parliament, they are also men, and we are talking to men. So we are saying whether you are highly placed, whether you are a member of parliament, whether you are what, it is not good. And if there are some among us who practice that, we condemn it as the Forum for Children.
The Parliamentary Forum on Children Affairs started an advocacy for a public shift to reduce the number of children fostered in orphanage homes, saying children growing in institutional care are deprived parental care and subjected to physical, psychological, emotional, and social harm with consequences that last for a lifetime.
Orphanage should be the very, very last option, like at most the last option that we should go for. We are not saying that orphanages should be closed down, no. We are saying, if possible, this should be the very last option that any Ugandan child should be subjected to. How about us going back to our traditional ways of looking after children?
Once you are getting married, you need to sit with clan members. Now, if you grow up in a child's home or in a baby's home, where will you get a family who is going to sit for you? Where will you get a parent who is really going to sit with your wise people to discuss cultural issues? So it is high time for us Ugandans to wake up. We need to adopt these children amongst us. Even me right now, I'm planning to adopt one.
MPs, together with Child Foundation, cited a case study of Toro District where all orphanage homes have been phased out for family-based care. They believe NGOs which support orphans should support them from their extended families instead of institutional care where they can't find parental love and care.
Even if we still have the orphanages in place, we may not immediately abolish them, but we are asking ourselves, is that the best way we should go? Can't we raise these children in our family settings, in extended families? Can't we open up our hearts to these children so that we can raise them in family settings?
I would like to encourage that we promote this as well, given that we have been children who have been raised in families, and give other children a chance to grow up in loving families. I'm happy that we are associated with the Parliament of Uganda because we have to make this known.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.